Okay, boaters, boat nuts everywhere. This is a quick look at a prototype of the sail blade for my kayak. We're out here in Grow Dome. I'm using my GoPro camera on this because my other one doesn't have a charge. This dome is in too much shade to be used for gardening, and it's going to be disassembled and relocated when we move here. In the meantime, it's being used for the purpose of constructing our little structure here. Most sails for kayaks are on the front of the beast. That has a tendency to shift the center of effort and the center of lateral resistance forward, has a tendency to drive the bow down, especially in oncoming seas of any height at all. So for a number of reasons, I went ahead and built a mizzen-based sail structure for this boat. You'll notice that I don't quite have the same kind of profile along the bottom as most of the flat kayaks. So I've shifted my skeg, which is usually beaching skeg, because we don't have sand around here. We have rock and other nasties. Moved it back so that I've shifted my own center of effort directly into the area of my main paddle reach. Then this mizzen-based sail structure here, called a sail blade, for lack of a better term, is going to also pull my center of effort back, should raise my bow slightly, especially for beaching. If I'm beaching under sail, the structure folds up relatively easily. It's all built as on foam, folds up as you see. It's a number of ropes to pull it to get it to activate. It's behind the area of my swing, so even especially flat, but even extended, I won't be bashing into it. I have two control ropes, one on each side of the thing for swinging the foil. You'll notice that the foil is atypical. This is a crude model. I did all of this, by the way, in about 6 hours. The paint job is crap, but the foil is sealed with resin. This is a form of a foil known as an Model 4 KF, or Klein-Fogelman foil. It's made out of spider foam that has 100 pounds lifting force and is reinforced longitudinally within the foam. It was just sawed. It has some 3-ounce fiberglass cloth on it and some quick cure phenolic resin to keep it all watertight. It's mounted on a single shaft, which is goes onto a solid bar. This also is a piece of steel. It should really be aluminum. This is a lifting force and weight counteracting, because it has foam in it, the same foam that we've got on inside here. And this foil here is shaped to provide lifting force that direction, counteracting any sail force this way, plus provide lifting force against the weight of this structure. This is probably a little bit heavier than it needs to be. It's just a stick of wood. It's used to cantilever the thing forward for storage and to pull it up for activation and to stabilize it. I'm not going to bother with the ropes and stuff at the moment. We're going to intend to have a live demo of this in probably tomorrow. As you can see, once in place, you have a couple of control ropes to effectively use it like a sail. It's very lightweight. The control ropes run forward. Doesn't obscure your view in any way. So hopefully it'll be an improvement on a sail structure for kayaks. And as I say, it's very lightweight. And also, since it's made out of foam and it's rigid, you can use it for a number of different purposes, even when it's lying down. And if you ever go over in the thing, your kayak breaks up, there you go. You can float on that bugger for a while. So just a short little video to show you some of the boat crud we're doing. Oh, there's that t-shirt. Okay, see you guys later. It's early in the morning here. Oh, by the way, the whole kayak here is all skin on frame. It's a 16-ounce ballistic nylon that's been painted with Hypalon paint. This is the second painting in like 20 years. The first coat was blue. This is a white and black combo. This is all tied with synthetic resin or synthetic sinew. Up till this year, where I've switched over to this Robline, which is a form of Dynel Dux rope that's seriously strong. I can't break this stuff at all ever. A single strand will lift my weight in here. And it's a real nice kayak, really good for racing because of its form. No rudder or anything. It has a rear skeg and then the forward skeg for tracking and control. I think it's about 19, 20 feet long. Any other specs you're interested in, I can provide. This is fairly low light, so I don't want to go shoving the camera inside the boat or anything. And as I say, Kayla and I are going to take it out tomorrow. Hopefully we'll have the other camera charged up and we can do some longer range video of it on the water with the sail working. Got to figure out what the tide is going to do to me. Okay, that's it.